All right, so the hamstring progression, back to it, it works. We've had people last 3.5 years show it to us, and we're like astonished. And the same thing kind of happens across the board, and we'll get to more of that in a second. So day one, what you're gonna do is you're gonna have your athletes come in. You're gonna have them squat 3 sets of 5, that's straight across the board. We're gonna do the exact same thing with the press. Same concept there. Maybe start them with the bar, something relatively easy. Understand, we do know our end point. Then we're gonna run. Day two, they come on in, they're gonna deadlift. They're just gonna work up to a heavy 5. All right, pretty much kind of like what we did with the squat today. Just work up. Again, I don't know where that leads them. Just once their form starts to break down, probably stop them there, work on it. All right, then they're gonna do 3 sets of max pull-ups, okay? So chances are, new kid comes in your door, can't do pull-ups. we can do assisted, but big thing that we like to do is negative holds or manual resistance pull-ups, which we will definitely do today, and you'll get a little experience on that. It's basically an assisted negative. It's because we know that concentric or eccentric load is pretty huge for the pull-up as long as it's controlled. You know, that eccentric load is a lot more damaging to the nervous system as well as the muscle, and so we know we can, if you do eccentric holds or negatives, you're going to get a lot more bang for your buck than doing like a band pull-up. All right, day off. Again, though, it has its place. All right, C, we're gonna come back in, we're gonna squat. This is where stuff gets fun. This is where the linear progression progresses. All right, so he say squatted, we'll just say 100 pounds just to make it easy. Day one, day two, we're gonna add 5 pounds to the bar. He's gonna squat 105 pounds. So this is where the parentheses. So he comes in, 3 sets of 5, straight across the board, warms up. He's gonna do 105 pounds now for 5. He's gonna now bench press instead of press, 3 sets of 5, and then he's going to run. All right, same concept, just find a weight that, you know, looks like they can move pretty clearly on. D, we're gonna power clean 5x3. Now, cleans and Olympic movements is where things get a little hairy just because it's more technique than it is strength, but initially it is a lot of strength, technique. We're gonna do triples here. We know that from all the old Russian books, like Zadiskorsky and like Mel Siff and all those kind of old Russian manuals, is they clean in 3s and they snatch in 2s. And the reason being, after about 3s on cleans, things start getting a little hairy, a little dicey. It's pretty hard on the nervous system. You guys know that in your own self, you know? After a couple cleans, things start going haywire, right? So we want triples here on the power cleans, and later you'll see the snatches at doubles. All right. 3 sets of max chin-ups, so chin-ups is here, pull-ups are here. Same concept though, squeeze the shoulder blades back, and same exact progression, working them up however they can get them. All right, then you're gonna take day off, chances are they're playing a sport of some sort. Then we're gonna come all the way back here. Week starts over, he squatted 105 pounds on Thursday. Now he's gonna go ahead and add another 5 pounds, and now he's at 110 pounds. All right, see how that works? Just 5 pounds every time they come in and squat. So we've been seeing a lot of that on the posting lately, which is cool that we're getting a lot more women and people using the program that are females. It seems to be like the common thread is to just lower the increments. So instead of jumping 5 pounds, maybe jump 2.5 or 3. And on the pressing motion and bench motions, we know that that is a harder exercise for females just in general. Smaller jumps there too.